before, and they write it down, and irrespective of what the talk is, they give the question. So the full talk was based on that. If you want to hear it again, you can take the video cursor and see it as many times as you want.
Yes, sister.
Assalamu alaikum, doctor. My name is Hisham Jafar Ali. I wanted to ask you if we are allowed to watch cartoons.
The brother has really asked a very good question on the topic, that are we allowed to watch cartoons? Today, the international survey, they say, the maximum damage done to any child is the satellite media. On average, an American child sits 7 hours in front of the television more time than what he goes to school. Most of the channels that take him away from Islam, including the cartoon channels, most of them. What you see, there's so much of violence, etc. So a person sees a violent movie regularly, whether it be cartoon or other movies, and he has a fight with his friend, and he takes out the gun of his father and he kills his friend. In Bombay, there was a serial for the children, somewhat similar to cartoon, called as Shakti Man, somewhat similar to Superman. So one young child, he jumps from his house in a tall building, thinking Shakti Man, Superman will come and save him. No one comes and saves him, and he dies. And when an interview was taken of that father, he said, I could not imagine my son would jump. Maybe tomorrow your son or my son will jump. Therefore, the impact of the media is so great that it blinds the person and it causes maximum damage to the children. That's why we have started a school in Bombay by the name of Islamic International School. One of the criteria to get admission is that you should not have a cable TV in your house. No satellite TV, it's a shaitan. It's a shaitan. So people ask me, then how will we watch Peace TV? Point number one, by watching Peace TV, if you're allowing hundreds of shaitan channels to come in your house, don't watch any, that is better. Let a small loss take place to prevent a big loss. But we have made provision that if you have a special dish and a decoder, you can only watch Peace TV and no other channel. So we'll see to it that's available even in the Middle East. Buy a dish, investment of few thousand rupees or a few hundred dirhams. You don't have to pay monthly whatever fees that you're paying out here, or 200, 250 rupees monthly. Invest a few thousand and all the people in the building can watch. Have one decoder, it will only catch Peace TV and no other channel. What we have, we can't create a vacuum. This is haram, this is haram. There should be a substitute. So we tell the parents of our school, don't watch cable TV, but we have got 5,000 tapes on Islam and comparative religion. Every day if you watch one for 3 hours, it will take you more than 13 years to complete the library. So by the time your son passes the school or your daughter passes the school, every day if you watch one, yet you not complete the library, and the next 13 years we may have one more 5,000, inshallah. In our Islamic video cassette library, we have cartoons for children, but they are on Islamic lines. So surely, my son, you can watch cartoons which are based on Islamic guidelines, talking about the Quran, talking about the Hadith of the Prophet, various cartoons we have got. But these cartoons get you closer towards Islam, not away from Islam. Otherwise, the other cartoons like Tom and Jerry, Batman, Superman, they have got no moral value. They take you away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There's so much of violence. So we have got Islamic cartoons like Muslim Scouts and various other cartoons like Fateh Sultan, which has a moral story and it gets the person towards Islam. So my son, if you want to watch cartoon, watch the Islamic cartoon which takes you towards Islam, but not those cartoons which take you away from Islam. Hope that answers the question.
The next question on the slip from Brother Muhammad Hussein Asadi. At the time of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, when he was alone, the kafirs' anti-propaganda turned in favor of Islam. Don't you think this time also it will be the same?
The question posed is that at the time of the Prophet, many people who did propaganda against Islam, they turned in favor of Islam. And that is what we should always want. I remember the second last time I was in UK, I gave a talk on terrorism and jihad. And similarly, the question of Osama bin Laden was there. And I said that the reply which I gave here, that the main person to blame is George Bush as a terrorist. There was a youngster who got up from the audience and said, "Death to George Bush," and people clapped. Now, I as a Dai, I'm trying to convince non-Muslims of UK with hikmah. And a youngster gets up from the audience and says, death to George Bush. And believe me, all my effect gone down in vain. I'm a Dai. Everyone clapped. I got up and I told our beloved Prophet, there were two Umars who were very strongly against Islam. And a Prophet prayed to Allah, at least give hidayah to one Umar. And Umar bin Khattab, radiallahu anhu, he accepted Islam. So we should pray to Allah that give hidayah to George Bush. Why should we want death to George Bush? If he's a strong enemy of Islam, if Allah gives him hidayah, he will fight in favor of Islam. So we should pray that, ya Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, give hidayah to George Bush, give guidance. And when I make this statement, no media can blame me. What I've said is wrong. So we should answer with hikmah, and we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he should give hidayah to such people. Ameen.
That's winning over rather than defeating the spirit of Islam. The next question from the brother on the left.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My name is Khalid Hussein and I'm working as an electrical engineer in ETS on group of companies. My question is, does Islam permit media? Because during the time of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there was no any means of mass communication as mentioned by you. So could you please justify by quoting any of the surahs or any sahih hadith? Thank you.
The brother has posed the question that at the time of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there was no mass media. So does Islam permit media? Can you quote a Quranic verse or hadith? Brother, point to be noted. As far as ibadah is concerned, what is mentioned is fard. This is the law of the Sharia. In other things, in the mamlaat, in day-to-day life, what is mentioned as haram, everything else is halal. For example, pork is haram, haram. Alcohol is haram. What is not mentioned is halal. I must ask you a question. Is there any hadith or Quranic verse which says that you can have mango? Is there any hadith? So will you say mango is haram? So in terms of worship, what is mentioned is fard. Only do that, nothing else. In terms of how to lead a life, what is mentioned, haram is haram, everything is halal. So tomorrow you'll ask me, brother Zakir, why are you eating mango? And I love mango. Because I come from India. And I'm proud of my country and I'm proud of the mango of my country. So first of all, you should give me contrary a proof, a hadith or a Quranic verse saying media is haram. Yet, brother, I will give you proof. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what he did? He dictated letters to non-Muslim kings, to the kings of Abyssinia, king of Yemen, of Persia, asking them, quoting the verse of the Quran of Surah Imran chapter 3, verse number 64, قُلْ يَهَلَ الْكِتَابِ سِيُّ people of the book, تَعْلَوْ إِلَىٰ قَلْمِتٍ سَوَاءٍ بَيْنَ بَيْنَكُمْ come to common terms as between us and you. Which is the first term? Allah نَعْبُدَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَلَا نُشْرِكَ بِهِ شَيْئًا. That we associate our partners with him. وَلَا يَتَّخِذَ بَعَدُّنَ بَعَدًا أَرْبَابًا مِنْ دِنِ اللَّهِ that we erect not among ourselves lords and patrons other than Allah. فَإِنْ تَوَلَّوْا if then they turn back. فَقُلُوا شَدُوا see, bear witness. بِأَنَّ مُسْلِمُونَ that we are Muslim bowing our will to Allah. He dictated letters and he sent them on horses. Today's little Mercedes car or what I want to call jet planes in different directions asking them to accept Islam. That was media that time. Imagine dictating letters, after dictating, arranging horsemen to go in different directions. He utilized the media to the best of his ability, what he had. Wallah, today if Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was alive, I feel he would have used the media to the best of his ability. But within the purview of the Islamic Sharia, not utilizing anything which is haram. Haram things should not be used, but what is halal? Like a knife can be used for good purpose and bad purpose. So knife per se is not haram. So media per se is not haram, though majority of the things on the media are haram. What we have to do is use it in a halal way. Turn the tables over. Within the purview of the Islamic Sharia, utilize in a halal way, so at least we can testify to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that inshallah we tried our little bit what we could to convey the message. Because our job is to convey the message. Allah says, فَذَكِّرْنَ مَنْ تَمُزَكِّرْ Our job is to deliver the message. Giving hidayah is in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hope that answers the question.
Jazakallah.
The next question from Tanveer Khan. For giving the answers to Hindus or non-Muslim media, should we have to read Gita, Bible, etc.?
The brother posed that to give the answer to the Hindu or the media, should we read the Gita or the Bible? It is not fard in Islam, it is mustahab, you can read. Because this is what Allah says, the verse I quoted earlier, in the earlier answer. Surah Al-Imran chapter 3 verse 64 says, Ta'alaw ila kalmatin sawa'in bainana bainakum. Come to common terms as between us and you. Now how will we come to common terms until we don't know what the scripture says? So in this context, we should read the scripture. It's not fard. I feel it is mustab. It is one of the strategies shown.